Hi, this is Dr. Arun Kannan, orthopedic surgeon from Apollo Hospitals, Chennai. I specialize in hip and knee surgery. In this video, I will talk to you about meniscus and its tears. Meniscus is a very important ligament in the knee joint. It is one of the six major ligaments that are there in the knee joint. Many of you would have heard about something called the cruciate ligaments, ACL and PCL. We have two meniscus ligaments called the medial meniscus, which is on the inner side of the knee joint, and a lateral meniscus, which is on the outer side of the knee joint. Apart from these, there are collateral ligaments that are there on the sides. Again, there are two of them. So we have two cruciate ligaments, two menisci, and two collateral ligaments. Of these, meniscus is a very, very important ligament because it acts like a cushioning inside the knee joint. So the meniscus absorbs a lot of the shock and load that goes through the knee joint. In bent position of the knees, it can take up to 50% of the load that passes onto the bone and minimizes the load that passes onto the bone. So if this ligament is injured, then the shock absorbing capacity in the knee joint is lost, and every time we load the knee, we put weight on the knee, the entire stress or weight is transmitted directly to the bones. When this happens over time, the bone gets eroded, the cartilage over the bone gets eroded, and this leads to arthritis. And therefore, this meniscus is very, very important for the longevity of the knee joint in the human body. So how do these meniscus become torn is something that we should all know and try to prevent. The first mechanism is often injuries from either sports or from two-wheeler accidents where the knee gets injured. But this is slightly less common than the second mechanism, which is ligament injury that happens in the anterior cruciate ligament or ACL. So this ACL is a very important central ligament in the body and is very prone for injury during sports activities or from two-wheeler accidents. When this ACL is torn, initially meniscus may not be torn, but because the ACL is torn, the knee becomes unstable. It often leads to slipping within the knee joint during certain activities if it is not treated. So if the ACL is not treated, the knee is out of balance, and when the knee is out of balance, the meniscus can get torn because of this imbalance. They get caught between the bones and they get torn. This is a very common method of injury to the meniscus, and the important thing is that this is completely preventable, meaning if you have an ACL injury that has been diagnosed, you can treat it, especially complete tears that lead to instability in young people are operated and treated very reliably. And if this is done, you can avoid injury to the meniscus. The third type of meniscus tear is often from osteoarthritis or arthritis in the knee joint. This happens in slightly older people when the knee joint continues or becomes worn out and becomes arthritic. As a part of arthritis, meniscus becomes torn, a little bit ragged, worn out and torn. So this is part of a degenerative or arthritis process. By itself is not important in the arthritis. If you get an MRI for a patient with arthritis, many of them will mention about a meniscus being torn. But when there is arthritis, then meniscal tears are considered a part of the arthritis, and the treatment should be directed towards the arthritis part. So we will look at what to do or how to identify these meniscal tear in patients without arthritis after injury or after an ACL tear. So when the meniscus gets torn, as I told you, it is very important as a cushioning structure in the knee joint, especially in bent position. So if the meniscus is torn, it often leads to pain when the knee is loaded in a bent position, meaning when you are trying to get up from the floor in a seated position, or if you are trying to get up from a squatting position as from an Indian style toilet, then the knee becomes loaded and it transmits the load directly to the bone and it can be painful. So pain with rising from seated position or climbing high stairs, these can be indicative of a meniscal injury. Secondly, if the meniscus is torn and it can flip into the knee joint, it becomes a loose tissue and flips into the knee joint, and in this situation, the knee can become locked. Meaning when the tissues get caught between the bones, the knee gets stuck in one position. So patients typically describe this very well as locking in the knee joint. Once locking happens, then they kind of move the knee slightly so that the tissue sort of gets freed from between the bones, and then they are able to continue their movement. But then if the meniscus is loose, it will get locked again time and again over a period of months. So the predominant signs or symptoms of meniscal injury are one, pain with bent knee activities and locking. So if these are there, then you must approach your orthopedic doctor and see if the meniscus is torn. Generally, a doctor, based on history and findings on physical examination, we can often diagnose a meniscal tear, but we all often confirm this by using MRI scan. MRI is very effective and very sensitive for detecting these meniscal tears and is the investigation of choice in this situation. It will clearly show the tear in most people. So once we have identified a meniscal tear, then the next step is how we treat it or manage it. Some of the tears may be superficial, partial tears in the meniscus, and if these are identified immediately after the injury, then putting the knee in positions of rest where the meniscus is not strained, along with physiotherapy and exercises, along with supportive medicines, many of the meniscal tears can heal. By rest, I mean that we have to avoid bent knee positions such as sitting on the floor, avoiding excessive use of stairs, avoiding Indian style toilet. Then along with this, physiotherapy will generally involve some modalities like IFT and use of exercises in a judicious manner to recover the meniscus. Over time, some of these partial tears can heal, but if the pain and the symptoms persist for more than 3 months, then we have to assume that the meniscus has not healed completely. If it is not healed by 3 months, then generally it does not go on to heal very well. So in this situation, then we are left to see whether we need to repair it by surgery. Surgery is often done through keyhole surgery, and some of these tears are repairable. The meniscus has three zones, as we call them. The outer zone has very good blood supply, so we call it as the red zone. The intermediate or middle zone has less blood supply, so we call it the red-white zone. The inner zone has very little blood supply, so we call it the white zone. Obviously, when there is a tear, we need good blood supply for it to heal. So it is mostly tears in the red zone or the red-white zone that we can repair and fix. To repair, we usually use something called anchors, which are specialized stitches that go and stitch the meniscus. We can do this using arthroscopy or keyhole surgery, and these are very good results. And more than 80% to 90% of the meniscus, we are able to stitch very reliably and make it heal when it is in the red zone or the zone with a good blood supply. However, if it is in a zone where there is not much blood supply, meaning the white zone, then it is difficult to make it heal, and that is why preventing meniscal injuries is very, very important. So if it is in the white zone, what happens is it does not heal well, and therefore we have to shave a portion of the meniscus, meaning we remove a small bit of meniscus to prevent further damage. The other thing that we spoke about is locking. Locking means the meniscus is getting stuck between the bones. It is like a small stone caught within your shoe, and it gets caught with movement, and it damages the surface of the bone every time it locks. So if locking is happening in a recurrent manner, then it needs to be addressed. And if it is in the white zone, often as is in locking, then we have to excise a portion of the meniscus to prevent further damage to the knee joint. So in summary, meniscus is a very important structure in the knee joint. It is a ligament that provides a cushioning effect and acts as a shock absorber in the knee joint. In bent knee positions, it takes 30% to 50% of the load, and therefore it is very important. When it is torn, it can be because of injuries or because of secondary damage from an untreated ACL injury. So when these meniscus tears are identified, we initially give rest and physiotherapy, and with this some of them heal. If they do not heal and cause persistent pain or locking, then they require keyhole surgery to correct them. And if the tear is in the red zone or the zone with blood supply, we can repair it. If it is in the white zone without blood supply, then we have to shave the meniscus. Thank you.